Evening, holy people. Welcome to St. John Paul II, and welcome to those who are watching on our live stream as well. Good to have you all with us. Good to get out of the house, I think, for most of us. St. Joe Road is not real good. Be careful going home. But the people who cleaned our lot here did the sidewalks, they did a great job. I don't know if any of you tried to do your own driveway at home. I did about three shovels, and I thought, it's going to be Mother Nature taking care of this one. When you get that ice first, it's just real hard to do that. My brother up in Indianapolis said they got about 10 inches where he was, so it's all snow. So I think that's better than any ice. So, but good to have you all in the house. Want to welcome any visitors that are with us, anybody visiting from other parishes or out of town. If you'd let us know who you are, just give us a raise of your hand. Any guests who are with us today? I'm not seeing any hands up. I'm not missing any, am I? Okay, good. Then it's just us tonight. Once again, just a reminder that the Adoration Chapel is now open from 8 in the morning until 8 in the evening, and you can get in for a private prayer during that time. I know we've had a couple of glitches in that this week, but we've got those worked out and should be available. We do not have bulletins tonight. The bulletin people did not get them delivered to us because of the ice storm, so they're going to come on Monday. Does a lot of good to get bulletins on Monday, but we're going to get them on Monday. We do have about 50 copies. If you do not have the internet and you want a copy, we printed up 50 copies, and they'll be in the back of church after Mass. But if you don't have the internet, if you do have the internet, we'll be mailing those out as we always do along with the Mass later on this evening, so you'll have a copy of it that way. Our parish school, JP2 School, is having their fundraiser Saturday Night Live. That is an adult night of fun next Saturday night, February 12th, at Huber's. It's going to have dinner and music by the Rumors. It'll also have a silent auction, a live auction. A live auction includes a Las Vegas condominium, also half a cow, half a beef. And then two raffles for his and her Valentine's Day, diamond pendant for her, Pacer tickets, St. Elmo's, Marriott, and bourbon for him. So there'll be two of those raffles. And so we just invite anybody who hasn't made a reservation to do so. Ticket sales in this Sunday night at midnight. We will have prayer ministry after Mass. Kathy, where are you? Kathy will be available for prayer. Just come up and see her. She'll pray with you up here in the front of church. I'm going to take a moment and find a prayer partner by introducing yourself to one other person and then praying for that person throughout this liturgy. And thank you for doing that. And let's just take a moment and quiet ourselves now as we prepare to celebrate our Eucharist this evening.
Good afternoon. Welcome to St. John Paul II Catholic Church. A special welcome to anyone who might be visiting with us this afternoon. Please stand and join in our opening song, Holy, 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 Lord God Almighty.
Amen.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Thank you. As we gather together, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate these sacred mysteries. Lord Jesus, you were sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You came to call sinners to repentance. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You intercede for us at the right hand of the Father. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have
mercy. And may Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to life everlasting. Amen.
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you, we give you thanks for your great glory. Heavenly King, O God Almighty Father, glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world. Mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world. Receive a prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father. Have mercy on us. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of for you alone are the Holy One. You alone are the Lord. You alone High, Jesus Christ with the Holy Spirit in the glory of God the Father. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. Amen, amen, amen.
Let us pray. Keep your family safe, O Lord, with unfailing care, that relying solely on the hope of heavenly grace, they may be defended always by your protection. We ask this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever. Amen.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. In the year King Uzzah died, I saw the Lord seated on a high and lofty throne, with the train of his garment filling the entire temple. Seraphim were stationed above. They cried one to the other, "Holy, holy, holy is the Lord of hosts. All the earth is filled with his glory." At the sound of that cry, the frame of the door shook, and the house was filled with smoke. Then I said, "Woe is me, I am doomed, for I am a man of unclean lips, living among a people of unclean lips. Yet my eyes have seen the King, the Lord of hosts." Then one of the seraphim flew to me, holding an ember that he had taken with tongs from the altar. He touched my mouth with it and said, "See now that this has touched your lips. Your wickedness is removed, your sin is purged." Then I heard the voice of the Lord saying, "Whom shall I send? Who will go for us?" "Here I am," I said. "Send me." The word of the Lord.
Day I ask for help, you answered me, you answered me. Lord, on the day I call for help, you answered me, you answered me. God of my heart, you have heard my troubled word. While angels watch, you name my praise. I dance before your holy place. Lord, on the day I called for help, you answered. Surpasses your fame. today I cry for help. You answered me. You answered me. From on high, from the heavens, the poor you see. You drive the proud to their knees. Though I live in the midst of trouble and woe, you save me and foil my foe. Lord, on the day I called for help, you answered me. You answered me. Or strong and come to my aid, you shall be all good to me. Forever shall your love abide. Do not cast your child aside. Lord, on the day I called for help, you answered me. You answered me.
A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, strive eagerly for the greatest spiritual gifts, but I shall show you a still more excellent way. If I speak in human and angelic tongues, but do not have love, I'm a resounding gong or a clashing cymbal. And if I have the gift of prophecy and comprehend all mysteries and all knowledge, if I have all faith so as to move mountains, but do not have love, I am nothing. If I give away everything I own, if I hand my body over so that I may boast, but do not have love, I gain nothing. Love is patient. Love is kind. It is not jealous. It is not pompous. It is not inflated. It is not rude. It does not seek its own interest. It is not quick-tempered. It is not brood over injury. It does not rejoice over wrongdoing, but rejoices with the truth. It bears all things, believes all things, hopes all things, and endures all things. Love never fails. If there are prophecies, they will be brought to nothing. If tongues, they will cease. If knowledge, it will be brought to nothing. For we know partially, and we prophesy partially. But when the perfect comes, the partial will pass away. When I was a child, I used to talk as a child, think as a child, reason as a child. When I became a man, I put aside childish things. At present, we see indistinctly as in a mirror, but then face to face. At present, I know partially, and I shall know fully as I am fully known. So faith, hope, and love remain these three, but the greatest of these is love.
Spirit and life, you have the words of everlasting life. Alleluia, 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 alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to St. Luke. While the crowds were pressing in on Jesus and listening to the word of God, he was standing by the lake of Gennesaret. He saw two boats there alongside the lake. The fishermen had disembarked and were washing their nets. Getting into one of the boats, the one belonging to Simon, he asked him to put out a short distance from the shore. Then he sat down and taught the crowds from the boat. After he had finished speaking, he said to Simon, "Put out into deep water and lower your nets for a catch." Simon said in reply, "Master, we have worked hard all night and have caught nothing, but at your command I will lower the nets." When they had done this, they caught a great number of fish, and their nets were tearing. They signaled to their partners in the other boat to come and help them. They came, and they filled both boats, so that the boats were in danger of sinking. When Simon Peter saw this, he fell at the knees of Jesus and said, "Depart from me, Lord, for I am a sinful man." For astonishment at the catch of fish they had made seized him and all those with him. And likewise James and John, the sons of Zebedee, who were partners of Simon. Jesus said to Simon, "Do not be afraid. From now on, you'll be catching men." When they brought their boats to the shore, they left everything and followed him. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
I invite you to take a moment and say a prayer for your prayer partner at this Mass. Thank you for doing that. I once heard a sermon entitled "Dangerous Prayers," and I found that to be a pretty interesting title. The priest talked about three dangerous prayers that everyone should not only know, but also prayers that every person should be praying. The first was based on Psalm 139, and specifically verses 23 and 24. Before I tell you what that verse is, let me tell you a little bit about that particular psalm. Psalm 139 is titled, "For the Leader, a Psalm of David." It begins with David acknowledging what we all believe to be true, that God knows us. This Psalm of David proclaims, "Lord, you know me," in verse 1. And then in verse 2, it says, "You know when I sit and when I stand." Even before a word is on my tongue, Lord, you know it all. Verse 4. And then later, this beautiful passage. You form me in my inmost being. You knit me in my mother's womb. The song, You Know You Are Near, is based on this psalm. O Lord, I know that you are near, standing always by my side. You guard me from the foe, and you lead me in ways everlasting. Where can I run from your love? If I climb to the heavens, you are there. If I fly to the sunrise or sail beyond the sea, still I'd find you there. It's a beautiful psalm. And at the very end, David prays a dangerous prayer with this psalm. Psalm 139, verses 23 and 24 proclaims this. Search me, God. Know my heart. Try me. Know my thoughts. See if there is a wicked path in me. Lead me along the ancient path. That ancient path that King David writes about is the path of our ancestors who were faithful to God. Now remember, this is King David, the adulterer. Remember Bathsheba. This is King David, the murderer. Remember Uriah. But he treads into dangerous territory when he says, search me, God, know my heart. It's a dangerous prayer to ask God to search our hearts, to see if our heart is faithful to God. So that's the first of the dangerous prayers, search me, O God. The second dangerous prayer comes from Moses. This is another prayer that you need to be careful when you pray it because God just might answer it. This is Exodus 33:13. Moses said, Now if I have found favor with you, please teach me, Lord, your ways, so that in knowing you, I may continue to find favor with you. Exodus 33:13. Every so often I'll be at a meeting, and I'll ask other people at that meeting what they think we should do about this or that. And sometimes they'll give me an answer that I don't want to hear. And I'll say, no, we won't do that. We'll do this, whatever it is. And every so often, one really courageous person will look at me and say, if you don't want our answers, then don't ask the question. That's how we need to treat this particular psalm, that teach me, Lord, your ways. Because this kind of prayer, this prayer fits into that category. Don't ask God to teach us his ways unless we are willing to change our lives to follow his way. It's a dangerous prayer. Teach me your ways, O Lord. It's a dangerous prayer, number two. But the one I really want to focus on today is the dangerous prayer we heard in our first reading from Isaiah. At the end of the reading, we heard this prayer from Isaiah. Here I am, Lord, send me. Isaiah is not afraid of the consequences of that prayer. Isaiah is ready to serve. These are three dangerous prayers. Search me, God. Teach me, God. Send me, God. And it's that last one that I want to talk a little bit more about today. As I look at this beautiful church, I'm humbled by how well it turned out. And I thank all of you for your kind words about our new church. And I agree, I think it is beautiful. But as I've said so many times before, if all we do is build this church, but don't at the same time renew ourselves, then we are simply changing an address and rearranging furniture. Today, I want to invite everyone, did you hear that? Everyone in this church to join me in praying that final dangerous prayer. Here I am, Lord, send me. And I want to get specific about some of the places that I hope God is sending many of us. I'm asking God to send 336 of you to our Eucharistic Adoration Chapel. Come this Easter, I want to start perpetual adoration here at JP2. Perpetual adoration means that we'll have somebody in that chapel 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. And in order to do that, we need 336 people who are asking God to send them to 1 hour of prayer a week in our adoration chapel. Now, we already have about 70 people, so we really only need, what would that be, 276 maybe. if my math is quick on the fly, 266. I'll be talking about this a little bit more during the Lenten season, but I want you to start thinking about it right now. Is God inviting you into that deeper relationship through that hour of prayer, through that holy hour? Are you willing to pray that dangerous prayer? Here I am, Lord, send me to adoration. I'm also asking God to send about 130 or so of you to serve in our Minister of Hospitality teams. It takes 14 people at each Mass to do that ministry well. It's simply smiling at people, welcoming people, acknowledging people. It's taking a little bit of your time, a little bit more of your time each weekend to make sure that others have a good experience when they come to our parish for Mass. 14 people at each Mass, 3 Masses on a weekend, and doing that once every 4 weeks is 126 ministers of hospitality. And you would be asked to serve only every 3 weeks. If we can raise that number to 168, then it would only be asked to do it every 4 weeks. Here I am, Lord. Send me to greet people as they come into church. I'm asking the Lord to send me about 40 ministers to help out at our children's ministry, back up and running again at our 2 Sunday morning Masses. I'm asking God to send me 40 people with a heart for kids to work in our nursery, to work with our children's liturgy of the word. We're asking God to help us build up our church from the ground up. We have great leaders in Kristen Kemp, Jana Gomer, and Tasha Pop, but they can't do it alone. Right now, we only have enough people in this ministries to do it every other week. I want that to change by March. Please, God, touch the hearts of 40 people that can love our young church enough that when they hear this need today, they respond by saying, "Here I am, Lord, send me." One final place that I'm asking God to send people is to that back closet in the church right back here, my right, your left. If you haven't been in that closet yet, it's the closet where we keep all of our cleaning supplies. As I said at the beginning of this homily, we have a beautiful church here, but we need 12 cleaning teams of about 10 people, or really about 14 people, to keep it beautiful. I need 12 captains. Right now we have 8. I need 4 more people to say, "I'll captain a team and organize a team to do that cleaning just twice a year." And the good news about this ministry is you can do it on your own schedule. You can do it whenever you have the time to get in here and do your part of that. But we need people to organize that, and then we need a lot of worker bees to get out and do this. If we make it happen, then it just happens twice a year. You would be asked to spend a few hours cleaning this beautiful church. You'd be heavenly dusters, if you will. I'm asking God to put in the hearts of 168 people this thought: "Here I am, Lord, send me to sweep, to wash, to mop, to clean, to serve." My friends, it's a dangerous prayer to say, "Here I am, Lord, send me." If someone were to stop you, though, in the next couple of weeks and say, "Hey, would you be willing to serve as a greeter, as a cleaner, as a prayer, as a teacher?" I hope you'll find it in your heart, the dangerous prayer that says, "Yes, I will do that. Here I am, Lord, send me." I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and life for the world to come. Amen. And with confidence now we place our prayers of petition before our God.
For Pope Francis, that like Simon Peter, he may continue to be humble in recognizing his need for Christ, eager to follow the will of God, and powerful in proclaiming the message of Jesus, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who are called to be fishers of men and women for God, that they may cast their nets wide with courage and faith and bring in a catch of holiness, justice, and joy, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For leaders of all nations and all in government, that they will use their authority wisely and well, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the parishioners of St. John Paul II will have the courage to pray dangerous prayers and be willing to respond to whenever God calls them, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For Mary Eckert, the intention of this Mass, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our prayer requests and for the intentions of our prayer partners at this Mass, through the intercession of Mary, the Mother of God, St. John Paul II, and all the saints, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Good and gracious God, hear the prayers we present to you this day. Grant what you find good in them, that our work might be the work of your kingdom. And we make this prayer through Christ our Lord. Amen.
As we join in our offering song, you're invited to bring forward your monetary gifts for the parish, as well as any canned food or other gifts for the Speed Sellersburg Food Pantry. Our offering song is Here I Am, Lord.
I, the Lord of sea and sky, I have heard my people cry, all who dwell in dark and sin, my hand will save. I who made the stars of night, I will make their darkness bright, who will bear my light to them, whom shall I send? Here I am, Lord, is it I, Lord? I have heard you calling in the night. I will go, Lord, if you lead me. I will hold your people in my heart. I, the Lord of snow and rain, I have borne my people's pain. I have wept for love of them, they turn away. I will break
above alone. I will speak my word to them. Whom shall I send? Here I am, Lord. Is it I, Lord? I have heard you calling in the night. I will go.
Pray, my sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours might be acceptable to Almighty God. May the Lord accept the sacrifice at our hands for the praise and glory of God's name, for our good and the good of all God's holy church. Amen. O Lord our God, you once established these created things to sustain us in our weakness. Grant, we pray, that they may become for us now the sacrament of eternal life, through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
And let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Almighty and Eternal God. For you laid the foundations of the world, and have arranged the changing of times and seasons. You formed us in your own image and set us over the whole world in all its wonder, as stewards in your name over all you have made, and to forever praise you in your mighty works through Jesus Christ, who is our Lord. And so with all the angels and all the saints, we too praise you, as in joyful celebration we acclaim.
Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Hosanna, Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and giving thanks, he broke it. He gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In the same way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for all for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. We humbly pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, with Charles, our Bishop, with all the bishops, all the clergy, and all your holy people. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. And have mercy on us all, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, with St. John Paul II, and with all the saints who have pleased you throughout the age, we too may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus the Christ. Through him and with him and in him, Almighty God, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen, 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 amen.
As Jesus taught us, we dare to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, from every evil, and graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you." Look not on our sins then, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. And the peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Thank you, and let's share with one another now a sign of Christ's peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Grant us peace, grant us peace.
And behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sin of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed. And may the body and blood of Christ preserve us all unto everlasting life. Amen.
By the body and blood, by your life and your love, renew us. May your sacrifice be forgiveness in me. Heal us. We come to you. We come to you. In the body of Christ, we are brought to new life. Restore us. May the flesh that we eat and the blood that we drink save us. We come to you, broken, hungry. We come to you. We come to you. By the faith we profess and the sins we confess, mold us. We are brought to our knees at the altar of peace. Change us. We come to you. We come to you. To you, make us whole again. May the word we receive be the faith we believe. Teach us. Mysteries draw us into the feast. Feed us. we come to you.
Let us pray. O God, you have willed that we be partakers in the one bread and the one chalice. Grant us, we pray, so to live, that made one in Christ, we may joyfully bear fruit for the salvation of the world. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. Be careful as you're walking out there. There may still be some slick spots of ice here and there, so be careful as you're leaving. If you're interested in helping out in any of those things that I mentioned today, if you shoot me an email, that'd be the best way, and then I'll forward it to the right people that would be able to help you out and get you started in those various ministries. I do thank you for your participation. One more announcement. This was Chris's first time cantering. I think he did a great job. I don't know about you. And I do thank all of you for your participation in this liturgy as I ask God's blessing upon you. The Lord be with you. May the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit come down upon you and be with you forever and ever. Amen. Go forth in peace, glorifying God by your life. Thanks be to God.
Go out to all the world and tell the good news. Tell the good news. Go out to all the world and tell the good. Tell the good news.
Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord, all you nations. Glorify him. Glorify him, you people. Go out to all the world and tell the good news. Tell the good news. Go out to all the world and tell the good news. Tell the good news. Steadfast, steadfast in his kindness towards us, and the faithfulness of the Lord endures. I'll go out to all the world and tell the good news. Tell the good news. Go out to all the world and tell the good news. Tell the good news. Tell the good news.